we have seen some just horrible accidents involving school buses. This one in July, 19 students were hurt in a Weld County crash. Nobody was killed, and none of the students was wearing a seatbelt. You know, fatalities in school bus crashes are extremely rare, so should buses bother having seatbelts?
Some buses have them, many don't. And tonight, Denver 7's investigative reporter Jace Larson goes 360.
Check the engine, make sure we have oil.
This is what it looks like every school morning. Drivers heading out to pick up your kids.
We're getting them to and from safely.
So why do so many of the buses in the metro area not have seatbelts for kids?
Superstar soccer player and extremely smart.
Lillian Beauchamp keeps her son's desk the way it was when he died at 9 years old on this school bus, a bus that had the old lap belts, but not three-point shoulder straps.
You just think about the things that you've missed.
Lillian wants to prevent other parents from the agonizing loss that her family's endured, and she thinks that all buses should have the shoulder belts. Tonight, multiple perspectives on the school bus seatbelt issue. First up in this buckle debate, NTSB investigator Tom Barth.
The history of crashes, we're starting to see just an undeniable benefit of the lap shoulder belt.
This summer, the NTSB came out with a new position. All new buses should have three-point seatbelts. Those are the ones with a shoulder and a lap strap. He says we shouldn't just have lap belts, and we certainly shouldn't have no seatbelts at all. But his agency only makes suggestions. So now let's unbuckle some other perspectives.
You know, school buses has always been the safest mode of transportation.
Nicole Portee is Denver Public Schools transportation director. Her view, seatbelts are great, but not essential. She points out how unlikely it is that a child will die on a school bus. Only 4 to 6 students die nationally every year. For some perspective, 40,000 people died last year in other vehicles in the U.S. DPS has about 400 buses. Some have no seatbelts, some just lap belts. And only 3 large buses and 24 smaller ones have the shoulder belts that NTSB now recommends. And get this, even when there's seatbelts on a bus, students aren't required to wear them.
We here in Denver Public Schools take a lot of time to ensure that our drivers are trained on defensive driving.
Portee also says seats are designed to keep kids in the seating area during a crash. With all this, she's not in favor of retrofitting the district's 400 buses.
How much of this comes down to money?
I think a big portion of it.
Installing seatbelts on current buses runs about $10,000 per bus.
My view is that money should be spent in the classroom.
We should all stop and look in the rearview mirror, says the president of the bus drivers union in town. He says, look at how many students were cramming on a bus.
The buses are packed. High school kids are larger than they used to be. And so when you have that many children kind of crammed into a bus for a short period of time, you can't really feasibly put seatbelts on.
His solution? Fix the school bus driver shortage in our state by paying drivers more than the $18.52 they get in Denver. He says then you'll be able to have more buses that aren't packed full.
And you put them 3 to a seat because you're loading to capacity. The kid in the outside is going to be hanging off of the seat.
Bus driver Chris Stambaugh's view from her driver's seat is a bit different.
Have you ever had a crash or a near crash?
I have.
A car hit her bus after veering into her lane. She wonders, in a big emergency, could students really get their buckles undone fast enough? She would rather see the money go towards safety in a different way, educating all of us what to do when we see this.
Adults on the road are just totally oblivious sometimes.
There are plenty of perspectives, and so far Colorado and its lawmakers haven't done what these other states have done and mandated seatbelts in buses statewide. Lillian will never know if these three-point shoulder and lap belts would have saved her son, but she wishes he'd had the chance.
We get through it, and like I said, we just honor him.
In Denver, Jace Larson, Denver 7.
And Denver Public Schools transportation director says she is in favor of those three-point seat belts in the future, but of course there's no guarantee the money will be there.